topic in the field of mining and petroleum industries. And so apart from that, this was nice research we had the blasting. Blasting design is very important because in blasting designing, software can have a lot of impact. And mine support design. Mine support design is again is a very important for the construction as well as the mining industry. The blasting software. There are a lot of blasting software in the market, but the one on which I have worked, and that's why I made this slide on the BlastPart.in. Now, BlastPart.in is a blast simulator. It will just envelop all the various properties of explosives and the rock, and based on those properties, it will simulate an environment which will give us an indication about the kind of contour which will be generated at the end of the explosive, at the end of the blast. In the blast part, what it does, like, it considers the various properties of the rock, the physical properties of the rock, like the Young's modulus of elasticity, the Poisson's ratio, the dynamic resistance of the rock, the density of the rock, and apart from that, like the burden and spacing of the rock, the polar size, the subgrade drilling, charge length, charge column, all dia properties, and all these parameters are fed into the BlastPart. And it will generate a profile based on this data. Suppose if our actual blasting, now this was our actual blasting, which would have generated a profile on the face of the OP in this pattern, which is not efficient at all because it will increase the cost of the mining as well as, and which will indirectly affect the profit of any company. So efficient blasting is much more important for a mining or a construction industry to survive. Now what would have been done with the help of the BlastPart.in? If we did this kind of profile, so the blasting contour which have been generated, the data which we have used here, the data basically are the X1 and X2 and the L1 and N2, which are the hole length and the charge length. And these data will be fed up in the BlastPart.in and which will generate a simulation. And it will give us a host of results, like it will give us a 20 to 30 solutions, and based on which we can decide like which is the cost effective results, and accordingly we can plan our mining activity in that manner. There is an image of some blasting which have been. This particular blasting was done with the help of the BlastPart.in, and it was a very big blasting. And any error, like if we are not using the BlastPart.in and we are just going by the hit and try method and using the human skills rather than the software skills, then the company would have got a huge amount of loss. So, such kind of profitability for any mining company is highly dependent on the blasting, and that's why software application in blasting has become much more popular these days. Now another application of the software of is in geomatics, regarding which the GIS was already told by Navjot. And geomatics is a combination of the GIS, the GPS, and the software like Magnitude and ESRI, based on which a lot of mining activities like surveying. When you want to go for a mining activity, you need to survey a lot of land, and you need to know about the topography of the particular area where mining is to be done, or about an abundant mine which is to be closed, or a particular place where mining activity has been done. So in all these kind of activities, you need the help of the GPS, which has become very predominant these days. And apart from this, we need to help for mineral exploration, where particular mineral can be found, and like the depth of that particular mineral. All these activities can be collectively done by the use of GPS, GIS, and the software as I mentioned, Magnitude. I'll show you the image of one of. This is a particular gold mine which has been abandoned, and now the process of land delineation was going on, and this was controlled and monitored by the geomatic software which we used, and this was after the land delineation which has been done. So all these activities were easily monitored, and this shows that how the geomatics can influence a particular mining industry in every sphere. So that was all from me.